Another tutorial, guys. We're in iOS 13. I'm in my iPhone Pro Max, whatever the hell it is, the one with the three cameras on it. They're the Pro Max, you know, the fancy one. I'm going to show you how to edit videos inside your iPhone or your iPad, for that matter, using iOS 13 and the new updates that just came out, guys. This is wild. There was updates to photos. I did a video on that in the previous one. But the video, the updates to the video editing are what really separate the iOS 13 update. So with less further ado, let's roll. First step, click on photos at the top right here, right beside camera. Boom. The next step is we're going to select a video. I'm going to select this one I just took just for this. And I click on it and you're going to see two puppies playing my favorite thing. That's my dog Kingston on the bottom. And my brother's dog Kimmy on the top, and Kingston, get into half guard. Oh well, whatever. Anyways, guys, joking aside, let's get right into this. The next step that you want to get this thing rolling with is to click the edit button top right, as you'll see me hold it down, and bang, edit. We're in business now. You need to hold the phone up vertically because when you do it sideways, it doesn't really work as well. So I'll just do that just to show you. This is how you edit now. You'll notice here that it played it for me. And okay, let's just, okay, so the playhead is this white little head right here, and it's at the beginning. So if I hit play, you'll see that it goes through a bunch of nonsense, and off we go. I'm going to move it back to the start. Okay, good. Now, here's the thing. The video editing now has pretty much the same functionality and features as photo editing, and this is wild. Now, it's default set to this camera icon. But when you click the one to the right of it, which I'll hold down, as you see I'm holding down, I'll let go. It has a host of features, and they apply to the video. So you'll see here, auto, exposure, highlights, shadows, contrast, brightness, black point. Yeah, I can read, tint, sharpness, etc., 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 vignette. All of these features are now are completely available to videos. So let's go ahead and just click on a few things. The first one I will show you is auto. Auto, as you can see here, made a few changes. I'll click it again, and in a lot of cases, they get it right. Like, I'll just be blunt. I mean, Apple's got some really smart people working, and when you click auto, they make some really nice changes to the video. But let's assume that you want to do your own custom changes. So, as you can see here, as I slide to the right, exposure, I'm going to go ahead, click on exposure like I just did, and then here's the trick. It's basically just a little slider at the bottom, and it goes horizontally, and you can increase or decrease exposure as you see fit. Now, I'm going to increase it a little bit because I like the brighter look, and let's go with an exposure of 14. Then I will go to the next one, highlights. Do I want to adjust the highlights down? Do I want to adjust them up? Again, everybody has their own taste in video and their own taste in photography, but the main takeaway here is that the features that you have for photos are now available for videos, and it is awesome. I'm going to go ahead and click shadows, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to increase the shadows to 23. Contrast, I like contrast in my videos, so I'm going to increase it. And I'm going to increase it quite a bit just to show you the effect. Brightness, is it too bright? Not too bright? Let's see here. Let's go really bright. Let's go really, really dark. Generally, you like to go a little brighter, so I'm going to go with like an 8. And again, black point, this is kind of not something I use too much, but it is good if you're doing like color correction and you're that good. Saturation, I like saturated photos and videos, so I'm going to saturate it a bit more. Okay, we're going to color your world. And again, guys, vibrance, I like vibrance. Yeah, that makes it look a little bit more autumn-y. I like that a bit too much. And again, you know what, guys, as you can see here, let's go a little bluer here. And whatever, I mean, whatever works for you, right? But the bottom line is this is how you do it. I'm going to hit cancel because I'm going to show you one more awesome thing as well. So I hit cancel, discard changes. Now we're going to go back in. So I'm going to hold down edit at the top right there. As you can see, I did. The other option is I'm going to decline that phone call from my stepmother because I'm filming. How could she know that? She couldn't. I'm going to hit the third one in. And this is also cool. Filters. I might have to make an entire video on this just the hell of it. But here's the bottom line, guys. You can make video filters on the whole video. Do you like this filter? Let's say dramatic warm. I like it. Click done. Now watch. Saving the video. I mean, how cool is this? This is mental, right? Like, they're doing this to entire, like, this is a 23-second video, and it's going to apply that filter to every single frame in there. Most videos, you know, I mean, I guess the iPhone saves at 60 frames per second, 4K. So every single second is 60 frames. Captain Obvious is checking in again. But you know what? For a 23-second video, that's like 1,800. That's almost 2,000 frames. Every single one of those frames has this applied to it. So when I click back, you'll see here in the video, when I click on it again, the filter has been applied to the whole video. Guys, this is amazing stuff from Apple. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I've got a ton of stuff coming up. Thanks for watching.